Crystal Dynamics. It's clear from the lack of direct communication that your game's players are little more than dollar signs. There's no single thing more important in a games as a service endeavor than the goodwill of your player base, whom you need to return. Yet, with every opportunity you had and declined to communicate, you spat in the faces of those somehow bored and or loyal enough to stick around and offer their guidance. Now, in a world largely indifferent to your existence, when reminded of the failure you've managed, players gleefully spit on your grave, and deservedly so. You are unworthy of the property you are disgracing. You are unworthy of the players you've deceived, and you are unworthy of the patience people have extended you thus far. You are guilty, deceptive, forever scarred by the shameful failure that this is. It wouldn't have killed you to communicate. The players have observed you virtue signaling online and seeking digital backpaths for what you consider groundbreaking inclusion for Kamala Khan and this inhuman narrative that is decidedly inferior to the much more intelligent stories of prejudice that X-Men have executed over decades of comics, cartoons, and movies, but your constant and forced attempts at recognition are blatantly transparent demonstrations of the demographics that you're seeking to exploit exclusively for money by tricking people into feeling included. As a black man, your game is burdened with bugs and glitches so numerous that a year of patches wouldn't kill them all. You throwing some black heroes into the game ain't gonna make me shake when it comes to a friggin' purchase because your shit's unfinished. You kicked a Marvel game out of the door with only 2 villains and 0 locations. But the most egregious of all of this is that you didn't secure the looks that the fans would have come to have known and love for the better half of multiple decades, so you absolutely deserve everything coming to you. Reap the harvest of the stupidity that you've sown, because Spider-Man would never have made decisions like this, and that's why it's successful. I hear people propose COVID as an excuse for this abortion of a title, and it's supposedly been in development for years, right? I'm reminded of friends who have died and those who have lost loved ones and wish that they themselves were dead. But, you know, they're forced to struggle without a job to pay for the ability to live comfortably. They also have to support the remaining loved ones. So they don't get the opportunity to think about themselves too hard. I'm reminded of the essential workers forced to expose themselves daily to an illness that they can't even afford to pay for. I guess they just gotta live in debt for the rest of their life if they get it, right? These people are dealing directly, I'm talking face to face, with reckless morons, deliberately endangering themselves and the people around them, ignorantly bolstered by a president who mocks people wearing masks, only to fall ill himself the very next day. Is working from home tough? Is ignoring people tough too? You don't seem to have a problem marketing this turd on Twitter, though. What a luxury you afford. Your behavior is cancerous. And if you had just communicated, maybe it wouldn't have come to this. Scott Amos, my free advice in the way of course correction is to rebuild this experience. Games like Warframe, games like Destiny, they understand the moment-to-moment loop of gameplay that keeps players invested and coming back for more. This game doesn't have that. Your developers don't understand that. The half-assed implementation of some of these features that are so shallow that it's clear they were put in there because a live service needs it, but they don't understand why it's in here. A game like this doesn't work by squinting at other games from across a football field and figuring out, you know, the rough outline of what you need to put into this one. You need to immerse these fuckheads, immerse these teams in the industry titles that they parallel so that they can match and innovate. That's make better, some of the things on offer. Because right now, here's an analogy that I'm thinking of is if Marvel were an internet provider, it would be dial-up right now. It's 2020. If Final Fantasy was troubled and could be reincarnated, perhaps this can be too. This time, include at least 8 heroes, some villains, some locations. Make actually good, perhaps MCU skins and comic book skins available. Stop trying to over-adapt these skins, making them less appealing in the process. People will pay for what they like. You don't need to make them less sexy. Nintendo didn't have a problem with somebody's, is a leotard inherently sexy? It's the end of the world. You say you have faith that the content will make people return? For most people, maybe that's true. But I think I know. You're worried. You can't say it. But you must be. You could be right, though. These people might just come right back. The truth of the matter is, most people jump on whatever bandwagon is popular. These days, drumming up interest can be as easy as paying the right streamer. But the game has to be stable first. It's not, Scott. Okay? If I'm being frank, you have lost me. Me specifically, my money, I'm irrelevant, I'm well aware. But I speak on behalf of many who are, frankly, too indifferent to do more than just refund and stop playing. You got a lot of people who don't feel the need to make a YouTube video, who aren't passionate enough to make their feelings heard. They don't care, they got jobs, they got kids, they got shit to do. So if this game ain't what they needed to be, they'll drop it and go on to something else. There are people who are genuinely embarrassed for and ashamed by games like this, hollow experiences so incomplete, simultaneously insidious. $12 and $14 pricing on cosmetics when the game costs $60 itself, somehow lazy enough to fail to provide skins that are appealing enough to justify that kind of pricing. Y'all got the numbers. You know that this ain't doing well in a lot of ways, okay? I'm not even sad. I'm honestly shocked. In my opinion, it took talent. It took talent to fumble what I would consider the most lucrative property in the world right now. And this is a disaster. I wish you luck. To the hardcore apologists and unwavering defenders of this trash, I hope you were trolling. Because if not, you have been the bumbling, inadvertent assassins of this game's community. You killed it before it could get started. To the mods running the subreddit, in your attempt to preserve a safe space of only positivity, you have failed. In your out-of-touch and ignorant banning of memes, you have castrated the subreddit's ability to reach higher on Reddit as a whole and outside of itself as a community. You have killed the ability for the community to grow. Mods banned me for telling the truth, and I hope it helped keep their virginity intact, because if you aspire to be like this game, congratulations. You too have succeeded in failing. With every it's just a beta, bro, you've turned people away. With every it's just gonna get fixed, bro, you've turned people away. With every I've never had problems, you're just a hater, it's not that big a deal, you have verbally shoveled this game deeper into a grave that it can spin for the rest of eternity and for all I give a shit. Be sure to high five and shake each other's hands like the Jerrys you are. But remember, you won't be enough to keep this afloat.